time training, I'm gonna talk about 10 things that you can do to help you live a healthy lifestyle. And of course, as a bonus, it's gonna help you lose weight. So that's the first thing I want you to do, is to realize that when you are losing weight, it's not just about a quick fix. It's about creating a long-lasting, healthy lifestyle. So I'm bringing you 10 methods. If you feel like I just can't do all of these, then start with one, start with two. Slowly implement them into your life. Before you know it, you won't even think about the old way that you used to live. Trust me, you won't miss the things that you think you're gonna miss. I used to be just crazy about fast food, fried food, cakes, cupcakes, chips. Now don't get me wrong, I still love cake and cupcakes and ice cream, but I don't crave them the way that I used to. I'm not eating them every single night like I used to. I don't miss fried food. Sure, every once in a while I have the occasional craving, and sometimes I have it. So the main goal is to learn how to live a healthy lifestyle. So these are 10 things that you can implement into your life. You can do them all at once, or you can slowly do them. So number one I want to talk about is going to bed at a normal time. But before I had a baby, I could stay up, I was a night owl. We would just chill and hang out. And so when you're not moving as much, your body's not burning as much, and you need to get a good night's rest, first of all. But second, the later you stay up, the more you're probably gonna end up eating, the hungrier you're gonna get. Your metabolism will probably be a little bit slower at night because you're not moving as much, and you're not staying as active as you would be during the day. So going to bed at a normal time, having a routine, having a schedule is great for your body. Something that's just gonna be great for a healthy lifestyle. You wanna get up early, get on with your day, and move, move, move. Let your metabolism really work for you and not against you. So if you're staying up super late and you find yourself just chilling on the couch watching TV, playing around on the computer, you're probably finding that you're getting bored, which boredom can lead to mindless, senseless eating. So just a quick tip right there, that's one thing that I had to learn how to do, was to stop being such a night owl. Now that I have a son, that's not even an option at this point. I'm just up because I have to be up. Number two is to only eat until you're about 80% full. Now our body takes a while before it can tell us that we're full. Usually by the point that you feel stuffed, you've already overate. So you need to eat your food slowly. Don't think about the quantity of the food that you're eating. Think about the quality of the food that you're eating. Enjoy every bite. Go slow. If it's something that you've prepared, savor it. Think about the flavors, the tastes that you're putting into your mouth. Drink water while you're eating. So don't just eat, 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 eat as fast as you can. Finish what's on your plate. Feel stuffed in a half hour, because it takes 20 minutes for your body to feel what is actually going into it. So you could be so overly stuffed by the time that you finish eating that you should have stopped a long time ago. So keep that in mind, eat until you're 80% full. Number three is to drink water first thing in the morning. Now, being dehydrated is not a good thing. You're gonna be dehydrated throughout the night because you haven't had anything to drink. So dehydration can actually work against you as well. So being hydrated helps your metabolism also move along. So drink lots of water in the morning, first thing in the morning. Number four is don't skip meals. Before I knew what I was doing, I thought, well, I'll just eat when I'm hungry. And there'd be some days where I would just go all day long and never get hungry, so I would never eat. But then guess what? All of a sudden at night, I am starving, and then I would just make up really for all the stuff that I didn't eat throughout the day. And a lot of times, because I was so hungry, they weren't always the best options. And also, once again, you want your body to work for you. When you put food in you, a half hour to an hour of waking, your metabolism is starting to work right away. You want your metabolism to work right away. So eat small meals, eat frequent meals. About every 3 to 4 hours, eat something healthy. So don't skip meals. Don't think skipping meals is gonna help you lose weight. Don't think starving is gonna help you lose weight either. All your body's gonna do is hold on to things because it's going into starvation mode. So eat, 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 eat. That is the next tip. My fifth tip is to eat on small plates. If you have a large plate in front of you, what are you gonna do? Fill it up and probably eat everything on it. That's how my head works, that's how my brain works anyway. So when I see a small plate in front of me, and you probably noticed that in a lot of my videos that I talk about doing this, my mind sees a plate full. It's a small plate though, so my portions are very different. Tells my mind that I'm eating a whole lot because there's a full plate in front of me, but I've actually cut it down big time. So eat on small plates. Number six, get rid of pops, soda pops, sugary, sparkly drinks, whatever you want to call them, and stick with water. You'd be amazed how much sugar and carbs are loaded into fizzy drinks, into juices. So even if it's just fruit juice and you think you're drinking something that's healthy, a lot of times it's probably not. You're just taking in a ton of calories, a ton of sugar, and a ton of carbs. Same thing goes with drinking soda pops. So stay away from pops, stay away from fruit juices, and just drink water. Number seven is get rid of the sides. You don't necessarily need to eat a bunch of side dishes. And when you are, when you look at the list going out to eat, or even just going to family events, or when you're cooking dinner at home, why in the world are we always having potatoes and french fries and rice and pasta? You don't need it. You honestly won't even miss it. So think about adding more veggies. When you're out to eat and you have that choice of sides, ask for the salads, ask for the veggie
get
options.
Get rid of potatoes. Get rid of the french fries. You don't need it. Eat your burger. I say ditch the bun.
Eat the steak, eat your salmon, eat your chicken. You don't need french fries, you don't need potato wedges, you don't need mashed potatoes, you don't need to load them with anything especially. When you're eating out, or even when you're eating at home, ask for a to-go box. I like to put half of my food in a to-go box. That way I'm not eating everything that's on the plate in front of me. A lot of times they're large plates. And number nine is think outside the box. Don't buy things packaged. They're loaded with sodium. Yes, I know it's convenient sometimes, and I get that. You may need to do that every once in a while, but try to start eating just real foods. Try to prepare your foods. Try to have a prep day. So it's very important that you're not just eating a lot of packaged items. So if you stay away from all the boxes, that means you're cutting out cereals, crackers, let's say bags too, chips, just processed junk that your body doesn't need. So think outside of the box. Don't eat out of a box. Eat from fresh foods that you're preparing, that you're making. And then number 10 is have a prep day. I say this to all of my clients. In anything in your life, you have to have a plan if you plan on succeeding. Having a plan makes you successful, so have a prep day. I talked about not eating out of boxes and having things convenient. You can do that for yourself. You can take a day out of the week. We all can make time for it. And you can hard boil a bunch of eggs. You can bake a bunch of chicken and burger and cut up some veggies, clean up the veggies, put them in bags, put them in containers, put them in lunch boxes, label them, whatever it takes so that you can have the convenience of healthy eating at your fingertips. Just try some of these things. You'll be surprised at how strong you really are. Just like anything else that we do, it takes practice. So you need to practice your self-control, your self-discipline. You have it in you. You can create a healthier and happier you. You just have to implement a few new things that are gonna change your life. It's not about a diet. It's not about how fast can I lose weight, how fast can I get toned. You need to change your life. You need to be a healthier and happier you. I'm gonna add in a bonus tip. Now, I don't like to say this right away to people because it's not always gonna move you forward towards your goals, but if you're the kind of person who feels like they're going nuts without having a sweet, pick one time a week that you can allow yourself to have a treat. That way, all week long, if you're craving something, you can bank it. Bank it for Friday night, have it Saturday night, and then the rest of the time, eat clean, eat healthy. So thanks so much for watching. Hope this helps some of you out to get you started and moving forward in your health and fitness goals.